Hare Krishna. Those who are not humble are humbled. The Bhagavad Gita is a book that guides us for acting constructively. And one of its concluding verses is quite graphic in describing the choice before us. In 18.58 it states, Machittaha sarva durgani mat prasadat tarishyasi atha chetva mahankaran nashroshyasi vinangshyasi. It says, Machittaha, if you become conscious of me, sarva durgani, from all obstacles, mat prasadat tarishyasi, you will cross over all obstacles by my grace. Atha chetva mahankaran. However, if you are not conscious, the atachet, if you are not conscious, then what will happen? Ahankaran. Out of ego, you don't listen to me. Nashroshyasi vinangshyasi, we will be lost. So here Krishna is telling us that we need the humility to seek guidance from him, to become conscious of him. Otherwise, material nature will control us. So that Krishna talks about in subsequent verses. When 18.59 and 60 he says, Yadahankarma ashritya nayotsyaiti manyase mithyaisha vyavasayaste prakritistvam niyokshati. He says, if you take shelter of ego and don't listen to me, then you say you are not going to fight now. But nayotsyaiti manyase mithyaisha vyavasayaste, but your determination will be misdirected. And prakritistvam niyokshasi, material nature will engage you. And then the 60th verse it says, Swabhava jena kaunteya nibaddha svena karmana kartum nechasi an mohat karishyasya vashopitat. He says, by swabhava, by nature, we are all bound to act. And even if we say that, we won't act that way. Kartum nechasi an mohat. You are saying out of illusion you will not act, but your nature will force you to act. So basically, Krishna is telling us that we have to have the humility to recognize that we have a particular body with its conditionings. And the conditionings will drag us down to illusion and degradation if we do not take shelter of Krishna. So if we do not have the humility to take shelter of the Almighty, then our mind and senses become almighty. And they drag us here, there and everywhere in the vain search for pleasure in material existence. And that goes on from one sense object to another one lifetime after another. So we chase after the sense objects and humiliate ourselves in somehow trying to beg and get the sense objects. We crave and slave and beg and lament, but we don't get any lasting satisfaction. So if we do not want to be humiliated by our sensual cravings, by addictions, by the delusions created by the mind, then if you don't want to be humbled and humiliated like that, then we need to cultivate the we need to ourselves voluntarily become humble and take shelter of Krishna, become conscious of Krishna, take guidance from Krishna and mold our life in harmony with Krishna. The more we become conscious of him, the more we'll be able to transcend the obstacles which are created internally by our conditionings as well as the obstacles created externally by our conditions, and thus we will be able to act constructively and take our life towards fulfillment in this life as well as the next. Thank you. Hare Krishna.